Alright, we are back, and now we will bring you the top 4 game, which will be played between Harrold Khoo and Ronald Seet.
Yeah, and Ronald, very proud of his special team that he brought today. We can only hope to see what anti-meta set he brings this time to this top 4 match.
And the fact that it is top 4 will also tell us that even without the element of surprise, he can still win in a best of 3 set.
Indeed. So his team probably working out very well for him. Not too sure whether he bought this team to counter Big Six or...
according to him, he hasn't been fighting much Big Six at all. Which is, to his chagrin, what he brought to counter hasn't really been the meta, but he is in top card, he is in top 4, things have worked out.
Indeed.
Harrold has, I think, is playing a more standard Ryoga team.
So we'll see whether Ronald's special anti-meta set can deal with Ryoga, which is probably quite common in the format as well, but not as common in Big Six as Big Six.
Though if Ronald does have the so-called counters to Big Six, then he might do somewhat well against Harrold's teams. Harrold does carry some elements of Big Six. I believe he does have the Kangaskhan, Smeagol and Talon Flame.
Oh, okay.
To go with the Ray Ogre mode of his team. So definitely thinks that if you bring a team to beat Big Six, certainly, like, let's say you put Lumberry and etc. anti-sleep options on your team, you're going to have a good time if Harrold does bring the Smeagol.
But very interesting to see what Ronald will bring this time. Will it be another dual primals? We can see that there's a lot of success with dual primals this time. In fact, in the previous PCs, a lot of people have won with dual primals as well.
The last PC was won by...
by Emil, actually.
Emil's with dual primals.
Yeah.
The PC before that was happy fun times with Jonathan.
Yes.
And Ice Beam and Freeze Dry.
Yep.
Alright, so we will be going into the game, as Harrold will be bringing the Kangaskhan, Smeagol, Kyogre, Talonflame, Ferrothorn, and Rayquaza.
Yes, very standard team we can see in Harold's...
That's Ronald.
Yeah. And Ronald is bringing Kangaskhan, Kyogre, Weavile, Talonflame, Smeagol, and Rayquaza. Yeah, sorry about that.
Right, so it actually is a Rayogre mirror between the both players here. And with, in fact, all their members are identical, other than the Ferrothorn swapped out for the Weavile. So Ronald definitely having the... Ronald, you would think, has the better turn one if he does decide to bring the Weavile.
And we can see that both teams have Smeagol on their field, on each team. But will they be leading Smeagol? Will it be Crafty Shield?
Yes, Crafty Shield will definitely be a big move to bring in a matchup like this. Kyogre Talonflame does come out from Ronald's side of the field. As we do see Talonflame and Smeagol come out from Harrold.
Oh, will Harrold be doing the autopilot lead and go for a Tailwind and Dark Void?
Kyogre does get Drizzle off, which, well, that is not a Primal Kyogre.
Yes, it's probably a Choice Scarf. And that will hit very, very hard.
Though, after a Braver from Talonflame, not so hard.
So will Quick Guard come out in the play?
Quick Guard from Ronald, a bit obvious here, but definitely would bring a lot of leeway. We'll block Fake Out, we'll block Brave Bird.
Quick Guard comes out.
As Quick Guard comes out, as Harrold does not go for the Brave Bird, goes for the Tailwind, and we are going to see, I believe, Origin Pulse here? Or he just goes for the Water Spout.
We'll
take down a Talonflame and bring Smeagol to its sash. Though Smeagol is going to get a Dark Void out.
Yes. So Dark Void is going to come out. Will Dark Void miss? Dark Void has about a 60%
chance. 64% chance to hit both.
Yes,
Dark Void
does
land on at least one Pokemon. So are we going to see one of Ronald's Pokemon avoid? As we do see Talonflame avoid the attack as Kyogre goes to sleep. And that is not the Pokemon. Actually, both, either or, really. Because both of these Pokemon right now have the speed advantage. Actually, no. Because Tailwind just went out from Harrold's side of the field. Harrold really needed the Dark Void to land on the Talonflame, not the Kyogre.
And now Talonflame is probably going to go for Brave Bird into Smeagol. Smeagol's... if Harrold wants to keep his Smeagol, he's probably going to go for Spiky Shield. But I think it's better to just sack the Smeagol and leverage on the Tailwind that he set up on his field.
Yeah, in fact, it would be Ronald's benefit to keep Smeagol on the field as long as possible. Because Smeagol is not going to be really much of a threat. And every turn Smeagol is on the field, it's another turn that Ronald can wake up with his own Kyogre.
Yeah.
As we do see a proper Kyogre come out onto the field, a primal version, as we are used to. And with the speed advantage here, with the Tailwind up.
And it's quite obvious that Harrold is going to go for the water spout. Maybe Smeargle will go in.
Ronald choosing not to keep his Kyogre in and maybe fish for a wake up as Kyogre comes in to take away Kyogre's water boost from the rain. Are we going to see a follow me come out from Smeargle? Yes, we do see the Smeargle follow me come out. So a Brave Bird here would take out the Smeargle and protect Kyogre. But we do see Tailwind come out from Ronald's side of the field. So Smeargle going to be sticking around one turn longer no longer having the speed advantage.
Yes.
Water Spout will take out the Talent Flame and do a little bit of damage to the Rayquaza without the rain boost because of Rayquaza's airlock.
But Ronald calling the follow me play right.
Yeah, Ronald definitely opting to leave Smeargle on the field as long as possible.
Although
Smeargle going for the follow me, hoping to kill itself there to get in the sweeper under Tailwind, but unfortunately Smeargle still stuck on the field and did not get a speed boost to make it faster under the matched Tailwind.
But Smeargle did get the accuracy boost though.
But with a Kangaskhan and Rayquaza on the field, Ronald has both Fake Out and Extreme Speed at his disposal.
Yeah, to take out the Smeargle. So Smeargle probably not going to survive unless Harrold for some reason wants the Spiky Shield and keep it in this game.
Which would be a very dangerous proposition if Ronald decides to double into the Kyogre. Right, Mega Kangaskhan does come out from Ronald. And are we going to see the Fake Out onto the Kyogre?
I think the play
with the Protect from the Kyogre has come out. So I think we're going to see Harrold going for Hail Mary Dark Void here. Oh, we do see the double Protect stalling out his own turns of Tailwind. Fake Out does go into Smeargle and Kangaskhan will take recoil from the Spiky Shield as Rayquaza goes for Dragon Sand into the Kyogre.
Yes.
Smeargle fishing for a boost, gets special defense, not what it was hoping for.
So useless boost right there.
And here the thing is, Kangaskhan's deck is going to go into Kyogre because Rayquaza can easily bypass Follow Me with the Extreme Speed. So Smeargle really locked down here, having a really spiky shield last turn. And now the Tailwind advantage is on Ronald's side of the field.
Yeah, Ronald setting up his Tailwind later than Harrold.
Though you would suspect that he's probably faster regardless because we do see a somewhat bulky variant of Kyogre here on Harrold's side. Whereas Ronald with the Scarf Kyogre is not what we would call bulky at all.
Yes.
Extreme Speed does come out. Is he going to pick up the Smeargle? Yes, he does pick up the Smeargle. So Rayquaza going for the attack, which does not lower its stats. As Smeargle does go down, unfortunately, many turns later than Harrold would have preferred. As Double H will go into Kyogre and nerf Water Spout damage. Will not take it out, though Origin Pulse here would still do a good chunk of damage.
Yeah, and
we do see Ice Beam come out from Kyogre into the Rayquaza. Without the Delta Stream, it's going to go down. So Ronald falls down to his Scarf Kyogre will come back in as the Tailwind expires for Harrold, so Ronald is definitely the faster player here. Kyogre
but
is still sleeping.
Yes. So can it wake up this turn?
But actually, Ronald now in a bit of a quandary because the last turn of Tailwind is gonna be problematic for his Kangaskhan because a Gyro Ball is gonna take Kangaskhan out at this range.
Yeah, and with Ferroton on Harold's side of the field, it can threaten both Kangaskhan with Gyro Ball and Kyogre with a Power Whip.
Yes, Kyogre being the non-primal version. But I suppose normal Kyogre and primal Kyogre share the same physical bulk, so Power Whip is probably a damage roll on Kyogre.
Yeah.
As Kyogre does go for the safe protect, and Ronald will have to have gone for the low kick or power punch here if he's going to have any chance of taking this game.
But
Kyogre, he does go for low kick into the Ferroton. It's going to do about 75%.
But Kangaskhan is going to take quite a bit from the Iron Barbs.
Ronald's trying to set up a position where his Kyogre can win the game with Water Spout.
Mm-hmm.
As Gyro Ball does come out onto the Kangaskhan, we'll finish it off. And Ronald needs to wake up the next time with Water Spout and hope it does enough to finish off the Ferroton.
Yes. So it all boils down to this turn of sleep.
Harrold perhaps with a bit of unnecessary protect last turn as well. Because Ferroton was clearly the bigger threat. Normal Kyogre, do you think Water Spout is going to be enough to bring down the Ferroton?
Especially with Choice Scarf as well. I'm not too sure.
It does wake up. It does go for Water Spout. Is it going to be enough to bring down the Ferroton?
Yeah, we are seeing this.
Ferroton will go down to the Water Spout. And Ronald will take game one.
Yeah.
With a clutch turn one sleep.
Indeed. And Ronald running a very, very interesting Kyogre set, which I've run before, but not with as much success as Ronald has done here. So, It's not a very easy team to pull off, and Ronald, you know, in this match, you can see that he really pulled it off very, very well. Probably practiced with it really a lot.
Though again, the Scarf Kyogre not really doing all that. But the thing to be noticed is that the Scarf Kyogre really didn't do anything that normal Kyogre wouldn't do.
Yeah, except that it's faster, you know, because of the Choice Scarf. And the play here would be just Water Spout because you have the Choice Scarf advantage. White Guard, you know, in against his team would, you know, probably be very dangerous because if Ronald does not call the White Guard,
he's
going to be punished very badly for it. But I don't think Harrold carries White Guard in his team. Yeah.
Yeah, Harrold not having any. Perhaps a Smeargle at most.
Yeah, perhaps a Smeargle at most.
So we do see that Smeargle is not the variant popularized by Poker Alex, the one with White Guard and Crafty Shield. So you would think that it is the standard Follow Me Fake Out set used in the Big Six. Right, with game 2, are we going to see Harrold make the necessary. I suppose he doesn't really need to make that many adjustments, considering it was a very close game.
Yeah.
Tyrant Kalka comes out once again. Wait, no, actually not once again this time. Tyrant Kalka comes out for Ronald. As Smeargle Rayquaza come out for Harrold. So Smeargle again threatening the Dark Void. And we'll be hoping that he lands both Dark Voids this time. Though again, Smeargle does have the fake out option but has to worry about Quick Guard from the Talonflame.
Yes indeed. And in this matchup we'll see whether Kyogre wants to go for the Ice Beam.
Considering Harrold is the Mega Rayquaza, Ice Beam is not going to KO through Delta Stream.
Yeah.
No, again, he has the option to double into the Rayquaza with Brave Bird and Ice Beam.
So, will he Mega? Probably Mega, I think. This is a...
Mega Wing would take away the rain and give his Rayquaza more bulk and power, so I think Mega definitely would be the call here.
I don't think he would be...
A very straightforward Follow Me plus attack from Rayquaza this turn, actually, I think. Would draw the Brave Bird and perhaps the Ice Beam?
Or perhaps Smeargle would just go for the Spiky Shield because, you know, Harrold might predict that Ronald will double into the Smeargle to take it out as fast as possible.
I think the double into here would actually be the Rayquaza, which makes Smeargle Follow Me definitely be the safer play. As we do see the Follow Me come out, are we going to see Brave Bird and Ice Beam?
And that would...
Yeah, we do see Brave Bird into the Smeargle. We'll bring it to its focus sash.
And Ice Beam will definitely take out the Smeargle.
Though at this point...
Oh, critical, but not that it matters anyway.
Yes. Alright, so Talonflame is going to take the recoil and no life orb from Talonflame.
Aha.
So information that Harrold will take note of.
It could be Lump Berry.
Though again, it did bring Smeargle down to his sash, so... Dragon Ascent will KO the Kyogre if that is indeed the target it went for. So Ronald not getting that much mileage out of Scarf Kyogre in this game.
Yeah,
Brave Bird.
Oh, it does KO.
Dragon Ascent into the Kyogre. I think this is the life orb Rayquaza.
And we'll see whether Rayquaza takes any.
Yep, you do see the life orb. And now that it's at minus one, so I suppose if Ronald does not have a boosting item, Brave Bird even at minus one will not KO the Rayquaza. Right, and so Kangaskhan does come out for Ronald.
Kyogre comes out on Harrold's side.
So the weather will change rain, but without Kyogre on the field, Rayquaza does not have to worry about too much. No speed advantage either way, so Rayquaza is the first thing on the field. Though, again, Talonflame does have Brave Bird, and the option to Tailwind, though Tailwind probably not the call here because he has no way to protect Kangaskhan.
Yeah. So we'll see whether Ronald goes for the fake out. What do you think he will fake out into? Kyogre or Rayquaza?
I think the fake out into Kyogre is the easier play to make. Because you might want to try your luck with going for the Brave Bird onto the minus one Rayquaza.
Yeah. But and will it be enough to take it out?
I'm not sure because we're not entirely sure whether Talonflame maybe has a sharp B.
But we'll critical take it out. I think
definitely will. Yeah, Rayquaza not even taking any chances. Switches out, not wanting to stay at minus one defense, and goes for the Ferrothorn. A very effective check to both of what Ronald has on the field.
So will Talonflame go into the Ferrothorn slot?
Some does Mega Evolve, and you would think it's going for the fake out here. Unless he wants to go for damage. Kyogre does protect against the somewhat obvious fake out. And are we going to see Tailwind or Brave Bird come out? Kangaskhan does fake out. Oh, it goes into the Ferrothorn.
Oh, and it's going to take quite a lot from Iron Barbs. More than the fake out damage, actually.
Much more than the fake out damage. So actually, Ronald going for the double target into the Rayquaza, predicting the protect from Kyogre, which he did. So I think we're going to see the Brave Bird come in here as well. Oh, Brave Bird actually went into the Kyogre, so Ronald not covering his bases as well as he could have.
Yeah. Actually, Ronald at that point, I think if he Tailwind, it would be a better play.
Though I think even without Tailwind, he's still faster than the Kauga. So Tailwind not that, yeah, giving actually, him that much of an advantage. And might even make Jarrowball stronger against his Kauga's card.
Yeah, that's true as well.
So Talonflame still has the Brave Foot option, and now that Kauga has protected last turn, mm-hmm. Ronald could actually double into Kauga, but that's not a play he chooses to make.
He switches out actually.
Goes for the Rayquaza. Oh, is he going for the Flare Blitz into the Kangas to the Ferroton slot? He is going for the Flare Blitz into the Ferroton slot with Rayquaza cancelling out the rain. And we are going to see Ferroton go down to the Flare Blitz.
But
he's gonna take a water spout for his trouble.
Yeah. Talonflame will probably go down to a water spout.
So he's done his job by taking out the Ferroton. Yeah. Origin Pulse comes out.
And
so,
he's both.
Yeah. He does hit both, lands on the Talonflame, and brings Rayquaza down to a little bit.
It's about a 60% chance, 85
or 73.
Yeah. So quite high chance there to hit both. Although I've not had a lot of luck with hitting both.
So Ronald does bring Kaya Sun back, and now Fake Out Pressure is alive once again.
So we can see both Rayquaza out on the field. Ronald not carrying the Mega Evolve variant of it, choosing to Mega Evolve his Kangaskhan instead.
The normal Rayquaza definitely putting a lot of work by cancelling out the rain to allow Talonflame to land the Flare Blitz on the Ferroton.
So I think he did his work very well in that.
Rayquaza goes for the Protect. No, I think we're going to see a double Protect come up from Harrold actually to stall out the Fake Out. Yes, we do see double Protect. So now he does give Ronald the option to double into whatever he chooses to.
Indeed.
Which in fact he did, the Fake Out Dragon Ascent.
So now Ronald has the option to double into any one of Harold's Pokemon, depending on which one he thinks.
I think the bigger threat here is definitely the Kyogre, because even if he loses a Pokemon to Rayquaza, in order for Rayquaza to get any KOs right now, he has to go for Dragon Ascent.
Yeah.
And that will bring his defenses down and allow either of whatever Ronald has left to finish it off next turn.
So I think he will probably double into a Kyogre. Unless Harold wants to go for a very risky play and go for a double Protect.
Probably not worth it at this point, because you have to predict right and get the double and get the double as well. It's not a play that can really pay off, whereas he can still make it if Ronald chooses to double into the wrong thing.
So both players taking their time to choose their move. I think Ronald still has yet to lock in his move.
Yep.
Harold seems to have locked in his.
Harold really, he doesn't really have, this turn really hinges on what Ronald does instead of what Harold does. Because Harold's probably going to have to absorb two hits. But Ronald actually going for the extreme speed.
Onto Kyogre.
I'm not entirely certain that is going to get, but if Rayquaza goes into Kangaskhan this turn, this game could be over.
Yeah. And it's most definitely going to take out the,
he's going into Kangaskhan with a life orb boost, Kangaskhan will go down. And Kyogre is going to get an Ice Beam or even a Water Spout off onto the Rayquaza.
So I think that's more or less game for Harrold.
That is game for Harrold, I would think. As Kyogre does go for the Ice Beam, it will finish up the regular Rayquaza.
Yeah.
And we are moving to a game 3. Ronald perhaps not playing to his out as well as he could have.
You can see that in this game, the Choice Scarf Kyogre didn't really do much at all. Just came into the field and
it's not really, honestly, this matchup is not really one that Toy Scarf Kyogre can really do a lot in.
Yeah.
I mean, sure, you can Water Spout, but Water Spout only really hits one thing, Talonflame. There are a lot of resist on Harrold's side of the field. And I suppose you all have access to your own Rayquaza airlocking Delta Stream to want to kill Harrold's Rayquaza as well. But again, there's a lot of redirection with the Smeagol on Harrold's side of the field.
Yeah, indeed.
So Ronald probably a bit too in love with his own Scarf Kyogre gimmick, and he really needs to divorce himself from it if he wants to make any headway in this set.
But for him to climb all the way up to top 4 with Scarf Kyogre, it's quite an impressive feat by itself, I would say.
But
because it's not
to go any further, it's probably something he's going to have to drop.
Yes.
But again, Ronald has not revealed his own Smeagol yet. Is this the game to bring it?
Yeah.
So far, we have not seen either player actually try to go for Rayquaza speed ties yet. So, actually, no, there is no Rayquaza speed tie because Harrold actually Mega Evolved hits while Ronald didn't.
And both teams have Tailwind as well.
Yes. Again, both teams are very similar, only with the Ferroton swapped out for the Weaver. Weaver we've not seen at all. And again, Weaver actually looks a decent choice against Harrold's team. can actually crash the Rayquaza. It can fake out.
He can faster fake out
than Smeargle. He can feign to break Sashes and Spiky Shields, but he's not chosen to bring it yet.
Yeah.
It's an odd choice. If there's anything that he would be better off dropping the Scarf Cargo for, I would think it is to weave out the lead.
Yeah. Can just go for a very standard Rayquaza lead and just feign Dragon and stand.
Though again, does he want to Mega Evolve to Rayquaza?
Yeah.
So far, he's not shown the inclination to Mega Evolve Rayquaza. Smeargle Kangaskhan comes out from another side of the field. So Kangasmere, a throwback to VGC14, comes out. Smeargle shows his face as Kyogre and Danflame come out for Harrold.
The very, very infamous lead.
So, if Ronald decides to go for the fake out here, he risks going into the quick guard. And also, does he want to risk trying Smeargle speed against Kyogre's speed? Because if he tries to fake out a Kyogre and he goes into a quick guard, and Kyogre is faster, he loses his Kangaskhan immediately.
Yeah.
If he does make that play, I think he will be better off not Mega Evolving his Kangaskhan and saving the Mega Stone for his Rayquaza. So not really ideal for Ronald here. Of course, it's better than he would be if he had brought Scarf Kyogre, which would be totally dead right now. But
I'm
still
really
an awkward position.
What, Ronald is running with his Kangaskhan. Is it even a standard one as well?
Yes. Kangaskhan does Mega Evolve, so Ronald taking his chances.
Yeah.
Not going to save the Mega Evolution for Rayquaza if he did bring it. So are we going to see a fake out into a quick guard? Nope, we see Smeargle go for the fake out into the Tenor Flame. Are we going to see a double fake out? No, actually, Kangaskhan probably is faster than Smeargle as Double Edge goes into the Kyogre, I would presume.
Yes,
goes into Kyogre.
Yeah.
And will nerf any potential Water Spout, though if he went for Origin Pulse instead.
Yeah, if Harrold calls the...
He went for Water Spout, so a very good play for Ronald there.
Yes. So Water Spout not going to do any...
Not even doing much damage to Smeargle of all things.
With both Pokemon on Ronald's seat.
Though again, now... Though we do know the Life Orb is on Rayquaza for Harrold. So without a Life Orb, can Telemic take out Kangaskhan at this health?
Possibly, actually.
And Smeargle really, again, has nothing to do other than Dark Void. Or Follow Me, if he wants to take the Brave Bird for Kangaskhan.
He's probably going to go for the Follow Me.
Options definitely on Ronald's side of the field, with the Kangaskhan being the fastest thing. Well, Danflame does have Brave Bird, of course.
Yeah.
Are we going to see the Suicide Tailwind from Harrold's side as well? The Kyogre perhaps protect from Tailwind here, I think, will go a long way for Harrold. Since neither of his Pokemon protected last turn. Yep, Kyogre does go for Protect. I think we are going to see the Tailwind here for Talonflame.
Talonflame going for the
Tailwind. Yeah, we do see the Tailwind.
Yes.
Does Ronald punish with the Dark Void? Oh, he goes for Low Kick into the Kyogre. Trying to fish for Switch. He does go for Dark Void, and he avoids the Talonflame.
Oh!
Ronald does make a somewhat accurate call there, but unfortunately, Dark Void is Dark Void. And Ronald also showing that he's not running the Moody Smeargle. So, not going to get any advantages of evasiveness or accuracy boost. Smeargle goes for Spiky Shield, predicting a Brave Bird. As Quick Guard actually comes out, hoping to block Sucker Punch.
Sucker Punch, yes, yeah.
Which does come out. So Quick Guard blocking Sucker Punch, and Kyogre's Origin Pulse is going to land
on
Kangaskhan.
Yes, it's going to land, Will it be enough to take it out? I think so.
The rain is still in play. So, full health, actually even without... Yeah,
even the bulky Davian and their health will probably bring it down.
So, somewhat unnecessary Sucky Shield there, but I guess it keeps Smeargle around for one more turn.
Yep. You know, with the psychological effect of Smeargle being on the field, you know, a lot of players will want to naturally.
Oh, but Ronald actually did bring Scarf Kyogre.
Talonflame would want to target that Kyogre to
nerf Water Spout.
So I think if...
Smeargle will follow me, it's all.
Yeah.
Well, if follow me is a Brave Bird, then Harrold will get his own full power, single target Origin Pulse onto Ronald's Kyogre.
Yeah.
But Ronald really has no early options because his target is Scarfed. Has to go for the Follow Me Origin Pulse.
So will Ronald go for Origin Pulse in this turn because his Kyogre is more or less going to take damage?
Yes.
From either Talonflame or Kyogre on Harrold's side of the field.
Ronald really in a bit of a fix here.
Yeah, can see that he's taking his time to think through his moves.
I really don't see any way out for him. Yeah, he goes for the helping hand. Believing that Braveheart will go into the Kyogre. As Braveheart goes
into...
He's hoping that Braveheart goes into Smeargle here.
Yeah, but I think he will go into Kyogre.
Yes, he does go into Kyogre.
Oh, and he took out quite a lot of health. I don't think...
And Kyogre does Kyogre Pulse as well. He does avoid the Kyogre. Ronald getting a break there, but now he's going to need his own Origin Pulse to land.
You can only hope that Ronald picks the right...
Yeah, he goes for Origin Pulse and he avoids the Kyogre.
Yeah, the 85% accuracy really showing its true force of nature right in this field.
And Harrold still has that one more turn of Tailwind.
Yep. So will Rayquaza come out? Oh, Ferroton comes out on Harold's side.
As Talonflame comes out as Ronald's last. With no way to change the weather here,
you would
see a very hard... It's going to be a hard time for Ronald to bring down the Ferroton.
Harold just has to protect his Kyogre and Power Whip with his Ferroton onto Ronald's...
You see the Protect come out?
Yeah.
So we will see the Origin Pulse and the Brave Bird come out from the Talonflame. Oh, we actually do not see it come out. As Origin Pulse comes out, even with the critical hit, it's not going to do anywhere near enough to the Ferroton.
And Ferroton will probably take it very well, as we can see here.
Power Whip does land. Yeah, it does land on the Kyogre. There is Talonflame against the wall.
Yep.
Again, even if the Origin Pulse had landed on the Kyogre, I don't really see a way for Harold, Ronald to come back.
Yeah.
But I suppose the thing is that if Kyogre had gone down, and Harold's last mon was Rayquaza, then all of a sudden, Talonflame can Flare Blitz into the Ferroton.
Yeah, indeed. We can see that.
But again, Ronald... a Kyogre locked into Water Spout has no way to kill Rayquaza either.
Yeah.
So, Ronald's really stuck there again, because the Choice Scarf Kyogre just didn't give him enough options.
Yeah, and do you think that the Origin Pulse miss on Ronald's side of the field, did it really matter in that game?
Yeah, because it locked into Origin Pulse, he can't kill Rayquaza. And if he's not Rayquaza at the back, then he has no way to hit Ferroton.
Yeah, that's true.
So the game was locked up by then, even without the Origin Pulse.
So we can see that even though both players ran a somewhat similar team, Ronald's a bit gimmicky, Kyogre not pulling his weight in these three matches.
Again, probably not the best option, but he really wanted to bring it and it just didn't pay off for him at all.
Yeah, but I think doing Swiss rounds, it really paid off, you know, because not many people expected that.
Yes.
Yeah.
But here, I think he really should have made an adjustment, at least by game 3.
Especially in a best of 3 match.
Oh well. So we do see Harold will move on to the final, where I believe he will play against Wilson. Took out Eugene, I think, in top 4? Yep. So it will be Wilson who will be bidding to win his second Premier Challenge.
Yeah.
Against Harold.
Having very good odds with his with his Hex and his double primer team.
Alright, so we will be taking a short break and we'll be back for the final.
Yeah.